Hey, what's up? This is Doug with Design 8 Studio. I'm cutting through a stack of 1/4 inch thick acrylic and then a printed sign sheet and then about, a 1/2 inch or so of particle board. And along about then, I realized that I'd forgotten to put some hold down screws that I had drilled holes for. And it turns out that the vacuum suction of the acrylic onto that printed sign sheet meant that thing wasn't going anywhere. But I did pause the job and go ahead and put those hold down screws in and then continue. My LowRider version 4 DIY CNC is being powered by a firmware called Fluid NC. And it supports Wi-Fi access for controls. And there's also an option to add wired control called the fluid dial pendant. And that's not an official part of a LowRider. It's just an add-on that works great. The Fluid NC firmware is made and maintained by the same folks who produce the fluid dial pendant. And the two are made to work with each other. Bear in mind that all through this time of cutting, and even as far into the project as I can go, I still have a protective peel-off layer on this acrylic, and I leave it on there to try to protect the acrylic, and it's on both sides. This sign I'm making is very, I guess you'd say, bespoke, and so because the edges are not straight lines, everything has to be custom modeled to have these custom shapes to hold the LEDs that are going to shed light throughout that acrylic. Off camera, I used my 100 watt CO2 laser to engrave the shapes of the letters into the plexiglass sheets. And I've now mounted the LEDs into the custom designed and custom printed LED holders. And I'm actually attaching them to the back of the particle board that kind of operates as a spine for the sign. Here's an overview of how I have the back of the sign set up. You see the 3D printed standoffs that interface with screws in the cinder block wall. I installed a pulse width modulation controller with a variable dimmer knob on it so that I can deliberately undervolt the LEDs from 24 volts down to about 22 volts. This will let the LEDs run cooler, which extends their lifespan. This cool stuff is being made for a very cool, locally owned and operated business that caters to kids. It provides a play place and party rooms. The name of it is Ella's Playtown. Shout out to the owners. And they have a young daughter that greatly enjoys what they're doing for a living here. And they're opening a new addition called Fluffer Ella's Slime Co. It's going to be very cool. I have an appointment to deliver the sign and some other projects that I've been making to the client tomorrow, but I showed them photos and video and they love it. This has been Doug with Design 8 Studio, and I hope you've enjoyed this, and if so, please consider clicking like and subscribing. And until the next video, I wish you happy making.